This is Roosevelt with AutoNetwork. I'm behind the wheel of this 2024. This is the Buick Envista Sport Touring. And I'm going to take you out for a POV test drive. But before we do that, let's hop out and do a detailed walk around. This is not the Buick my parents owned. The last Buick my dad bought was a Lucerne, and he called that a Lacreme. I'll put a link in the description below so you can watch his entire buying process. This is the 2024 Buick Envista Sports Touring, a stylish compact crossover that strikes a perfect balance between modern technology and the classic values we baby boomers appreciate. Let's start by admiring this sleek design. With the stunning gloss black mesh grille and the sharp LED headlights and daytime running lamps, this Envista is sophisticated yet contemporary. Take a closer look at these 19-inch black painted aluminum wheels. They not only enhance the vehicle's sporty appearance, but also provide a smooth and controlled ride, perfect for city streets along highway drives. From the side, you can truly appreciate the Envista's sleek lines and aerodynamic profile. This compact crossover has a refined presence on the road, and the Moonstone Gray Metallic paint adds an extra touch of class. At the rear, the clean design continues with the stylish LED tail lamps. The power liftgate adds convenience, making it easy to load and unload whether you're running errands or heading out on a weekend getaway. There's quite a bit of storage here, especially with the splits folding 60-40 rear seats fold down. And you can remove the security cover. You can take it out. Or leave it in. Now let's step inside. First, I need to unlock it. There we go. Now let's step inside. You have plastic here on the door panels. As you can see, the door opens wide so you can easily slide in. The seat's five. The seat here has no high bolster, so it's easy for you to slide in. And there's lots of leg room back here. I'm 6'1", as you can see. My knees aren't touching the back of the front passenger seat. And you have a little storage space here, some USB connectors. And this is a 60-40 split seat. So that if you need more cargo space, just drop the seats. Now, I always suggest you use the door handles or the grab handles rather to get out of this car. But for some reason in this Envista, I don't like the placement. It doesn't make it easy for you to do that, to use it to exit the vehicle. Here you can fold the seat down. Gives you that extra storage space that I was talking about. And you can flip it up. Now let's check out the front passenger seat. You have some hard plastic here. You have the blue stitching, which is the signature for the ST, which is sports touring, lock and unlock. And again, you have this passenger seat. Doesn't have the high side bolsters or thigh bolsters, make it easy for you to get in and out. Has the ST logo embroidered here, the blue stitching. And this passenger seat is very comfortable. So if you're on a long journey, it's not going to tire you out. Now let's take a moment again to appreciate the design from this angle as we move across the front of the Envista. The attention to detail in every curve makes this compact crossover really stand out. You have your air intakes here. There's that black mesh grille, your ST badging, headlights. Lights here. Beautiful design. Now let's jump into the driver's seat. This is where you're going to spend most of your time anyway, and as you can see, you have your controls here for your windows, your mirrors, unlock, lock, and you have a control here for the rear lift gate. And you have a sports driver's seat with the blue stitching, as well as the ST embroidered in the headrest. You have your controls here. This is the 8-way power seat, and it has lumbar support. Here you have your start-stop button. Start the engine. And there's nothing like getting into a vehicle that has a heated steering wheel. Nothing like the warmth of heat on your hands on that chilly morning. Makes the rest of the body seem to be at a comfortable temperature. Here you can find your perfect seating position. Show that this has an 8-way driver control seat. And across the dash, we have a 8-inch driver information center that you have here. Gives you all the information right at your fingertips. Over here, you have the 11-inch color, and this is HD touchscreen. And this is the heart for the infotainment system. You can go here. It's touchscreen. It is a little slow, but it's adequate. You have Apple CarPlay that everybody's looking for, and especially Android Auto. Some manufacturers have talked about dropping that, and consumers are kind of up in arms about all of that. And here you have glove compartment, hard material, but the blue stitching, your vents across the front here that are easy to control for your air conditioning. Turn your air on here. And the body, or the glass panel here for the dash, is, to me, it's probably one of the simplest layouts that you can find in an automobile, and it's nice and clean. I'll show you how clean it is. I like that black background. Now you put this thing in reverse and you look at that screen. That is nice. There's nothing to interrupt your viewing of what's going on, and you really should be paying attention to where you're going when you back up. Now overhead here, you have your controls for your sunroof, and you also have your OnStar and your SOS buttons up there. And you have your sun visor over here that has the vanity mirror. You have another one over here on the driver's side, also has the vanity mirror. You can take a look at yourself. Hopefully you not driving along, you're just sitting still. But as you can see, this is a very clean layout. The center console, you have your wireless phone charger here, your shifter, a couple cup holders. As you saw in an earlier video, it doesn't hold my favorite cup, but that's okay. And you have a little storage pocket here, relatively deep but narrow. Parking brake control. So everything is right here at your fingertips. You have dials, buttons, and it's easy for you to use, easy to reach, so that you don't really have to take your eye off of the road as you're driving. Now this Buick Envista is loaded with a lot of tech. Some of it you can control, some you can't. But it has what's called a Buick Driver Confidence System, which includes a following distance indicator, a forward collision alert, a lane keep assist and lane departure warning, automatic emergency braking, front pedestrian braking, and HD rear vision camera. So you have all the tech that you'll need to be able to safely drive this Vista, either in the city, on the highway, wherever you want to take it. Now, one of the things that I want to let you know is the visibility. As you know, this is a sports model. But if you look around, you have a lot of glass. You have pretty much, you can see in all directions here. You have good visibility. And one of the things I really want you to pay attention to is if you're in a situation where you have to look back and you're not one of those people who can turn the head all the way around and see what's coming up on the side, you have a lane assist or lane warning system that's activated and a warning light appears in the outside mirror there. Well, before I forget, let me turn this air down, fan down. I am a big believer in adaptive cruise control, and this Buick Envista Sports Touring has adaptive cruise control. You control it here. You can set the distance between the car in front of you, and you can also set your speed. And with adaptive cruise control, if you know anything about it, it maintains the distance and it keeps your speed basically between you and the car in front of you. I think that's a great feature. It saves on that hitting the brake, hitting the accelerator all the time if you're on a long drive. Why don't we hop out and take a look under the hood and see what powers this Envista Sports Touring. Have your hood latch under here, pull that one pull. Quickly move around to the front. And here we have, this is a 1.2 liter Ecotec turbo three-cylinder engine, and it's a compact little powerhouse. And if you saw any of the POV test drive, you can see that it has 137 horsepower at 162 pound-feet of torque, and that is enough power to keep this Envista doing pretty much whatever you want to have it to do on the highway. It offers this engine. It's very efficient and it performs well. It gets 28 miles per gallon fuel in the city, 32 on the highway, and 30 mpg combined. Now, with its blend of style, comfort, and technology, the 2024 Buick Envista Sport Touring is an ideal choice for those of us who still appreciate the joy of driving. Whether you are commuting to the city or exploring new destinations, the Envista is ready for the journey ahead. This is Roosevelt. Enjoy the rest of the video. Please like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Let's see what we can get from a standing start. Well, this is a 1.2 liter turbo. It's not going to break your neck, but it will move out of its own way. Well, I'm doing about 42 mile an hour. Let's come to a panic stop and check out these brakes at this stop sign here. They work. Brought the tool to a standstill. Now there's more than enough leg room back here sitting in the second row of this Envista. As you can see, I have nice leg room here in the front, and I have more than adequate headroom. This 2024, this is the Buick Envista, the sports touring model, and I'm impressed with the ride and handling. It handles very well. As you can see here, the steering is very responsive, as well as the ride quality is nice. It has a little sporty feel to the ride. When I say sporty, I mean you can actually feel the bumps and the cracks, crevices in the road, which gives you that sporty ride. It's not like you're riding on a cloud or anything. This is a small or compact SUV, but the ride quality is impressive. Every now and then when the road gets rough, you do get some interior cabin noise from the wheels. But other than that, I'm impressed. I like the fact that this dash is nice and clean. You don't have a lot of confusing buttons and dials to deal with. I like the fact that this screen here is nice, it's flat. You have a screen here for your gauges, give you information about what's happening with the car. Over here you have the infotainment and navigation system. It's very easy to use, not a whole lot of confusing, like I said, buttons and dials. You do have dials here for your AC, but that's about it. It's nice and clean, and later on in the video I'll show you how bright that screen is.
In a vehicle this size, you're always concerned about getting in and out. And this, at the price point of what, about $29,000, you're not going to have a memory seat button in this car. So a couple of things that you can do to make getting in and out easier. First, one of the first things you can do, this Envista has a telescoping and tilt steering wheel. So you just push the steering wheel out of the way, and you can also lower the seat, make it a little easier for you to slide out, and it makes getting out a whole lot easier. Just slide out, step out. Now this vehicle is low, so you have to be careful getting in. It is a drop if you lower your seat. Just take your time, don't rush. When you get in the car, you raise the seat to your seating position. Again, just adjust the tilt steering wheel, lock it in place. Start the car. Don't forget, put your seatbelt back on. And you're ready to go.